Good morning, my dear students. Welcome back to this new video. In this video, we will learn about primary memory and computer memory.
Can you remember what are the events happened in your life last week? Yes, we can remember and easily recall also, because of human beings have memory to store these events and recalls whenever requires. Like these human beings, computer also has memory. What is the use of this computer memory? Computer memory store all the data and instructions required by the computer. Each and every object has storage capacity. If you are taking one bucket, that bucket can hold 5 liters of water. If you are taking one mug, that mug may be hold 1/2 liter water. Same way, the computer memory also has the storage capacity. This computer memory also measured by the standard units bits and bytes. What is bit? A small unit of computer memory is called bit. What is bit? A small unit of computer memory is called bit. The bit full form is binary digit. This bit can store one of two values, 0 or 1. Did you get it? The bit have one digit. It may be a 0 or 1. This bit is denoted by small letter B. Did you get bit? Next, byte. A byte is a collection of 8 bits. 8 bits means 8 digit. Bit is one digit here. Byte is 8 digit. Here, one byte required to store one single character. This character may be a numbers or alphabets or special symbols. This byte is denoted by capital letter B. Did you get what is byte? It is a collection of 8 bit. Here, measurement table. 1 byte equal to 8 bit. 1 kilobyte. Kilobyte short form KB. 1 KB equal to 1024 bytes. 1 megabyte equal to megabyte short form MB. 1 MB equal to 1024 kilobyte. 1 gigabyte. Gigabyte short form is GB. That is equal to 1 GB is equal to 1024 megabyte. 1 terabyte. Terabyte short form is TB. 1 TB equal to 1024 gigabyte. This is the measurement table of this bit and byte. Computer memories are two types of primary memory and secondary memory. First type of memory is primary memory. It is also known as internal memory or main memory. It stores the data and instruction for the processing. What are the data and instructions are needed to calculation that are stored in this primary memory? This primary memory only directly communicate with the CPU. This primary memory has two types, RAM and ROM. First type of primary memory is RAM. RAM refers to random access memory. Here, what are the instructions are required for the calculation that is stored in the RAM? We can take the data from this memory as well as we can store the data also. So, it is known as read or write memory. Why it is called read or write memory? We can take the data from this memory as well as we can store the data to the memory. That's why it is called read and write memory. Did you get him? When the power is switched off, all the information in the memory will lose. There are several types of RAM. They are DRAM, SRAM, SDRAM, DDR. First we will say about DRAM. DRAM full form is dynamic random access memory. It stores the data for short period of time. After the time interval, the data is erased from the memory. Next type of memory is SRAM. Full form is static random access memory. It retains the stored data as long as the power is available in the computer. Did you get it? Whenever the power is available, the data is in the RAM only. That is a DRAM. Next memory is SDRAM. That full form is synchronized dynamic random access memory. It can deliver the large volume of data at high speed. The previous memories we can store less amount of data only. Here in this memory we can store large amount of data at high speed. Next RAM is DDR. Full form is double data rate memory. Double data rate memory. This memory uses less power. It has double speed compared to the SDRAM. Okay, SDRAM already we studied. It is a high speed memory. That double speed is which one? DDR. Second type of primary memory is ROM. ROM refers to read-only memory. What are the files are recorded to working a computer? That all important files are stored in this ROM. What are the things are we are stored in the computer that permanently store no more modification on the data? Understand? That is the ROM. There are several types of ROM. They are PROM, EPROM, EEPROM and flash memory. First we will see about PROM. PROM full form is programmable read-only memory. In this memory, we can store the data using the computer program or software. Next memory is EPROM. EPROM full form is erasable programmable read-only memory. In the PROM, once we are written the program, we can't erase from the memory. That's why we are using the EPROM. EPROM is used to erase the ultraviolet light. Next memory is EPROM. EPROM full form is erasable programmable read-only memory. Here in this memory, once we are written in the memory, we cannot erase the data from this memory. So we can use the ultraviolet light to erase the data from the memory and reprogrammed. Next memory is EEPROM. That full form is electrically erasable programmable read-only memory. In this memory, content can be erased and reprogrammed using the electrical signal. Next memory is flash memory. The content are erased using single action of flash. It is very small in size. It is commonly used in mobile phones, notebook computers and so on.
Okay children, in this video we studied about primary memory and its classification. Next video we will study about secondary memory. Thank you dear children.